Stress under ideal conditions is how we grow. Stress is not a bad thing. It's the strain that we've got to. It's the stress response or the strain that we've got to control. Next time a stressor appears in your life, understand that if we handle that stress correctly, we can use it to grow. We can use it to get bigger. We can use it to get better. So stress isn't necessarily the problem. It's the response to the stress that is the problem. So we've got several parts working here when it comes to this whole hyperpigmentation issue. We've got the adrenal glands. We've got the stress response. We've got the skin and the sex hormone connection, specifically estrogen. So the first thing to consider if you're dealing with hyperpigmentation is the stress response, which is managed by the adrenal glands. The adrenal glands are your last firewall against attack. The adrenal glands are the body's third and last protective system after the intestines and the liver. So the intestine is actually the major, the most important protective element, guardian of the blood, if you will, and that's because we eat. Eating is the most intrusive thing that we do to our bodies. It's the most offensive thing we do to our bodies. I'm not saying we not to eat, but we got to be careful about eating. The intestines have evolved to protect us from food. Over the course of time, we've talked about this many, many times in this program, over the course of the years and the decades, this intestinal system, this intestinal guardian breaks down. It's called leaky gut syndrome or intestinal permeability syndrome. And everybody has it to a certain degree. Just because we live in 21st century America, we're eating 21st century American food. We're eating food that doesn't have enzymes in it. We're eating food that doesn't have nutrients in it. We're not supplementing for the most part. Most people aren't anyway. There's no way we can't suffer from health crises under all of these conditions. Well, fortunately, we've got a secondary protective system after the intestine, and that's the liver. Food goes through the digestive tract, it goes into the intestines, through the intestine it goes into the blood, and then it goes into the liver. And then the liver is like a second protective guardian. Well, of course, we know that our livers are overloaded because of too much toxicity, because of we're eating the wrong foods, stuff is getting into the blood that shouldn't get into the blood, prescription drugs and illegal drugs, pollutants, all of these combine to put a stress on the liver. So then you're dealing with the third guardian, and that is the adrenal glands. The adrenal glands are absolutely, absolutely imperative to life. Autoimmune disease of the adrenal glands, Addison's disease, is one of the most significant of all autoimmune conditions. Luckily, it's rare. One in about 100,000 people have Addison's disease. John F. Kennedy famously had Addison's disease, and he was using topical steroids. If you ever look at pictures of JFK, President Kennedy, from like the 1940s and 1950s, he looks really skinny. And then when he was president, he kind of had sort of chunky cheeks, sort of got a little puffy. That's because he was taking prednisone. He was taking steroid drugs because he had Addison's disease. The adrenal glands play an important role in stimulating fire, cellular fire. It's called oxidation. So you're under stress, the adrenal glands kick in with cortisol, and cortisol causes a burning, increases the fiery nature of the body. And this has a good side and also has a bad side. We'll talk about that when we come back from our break. I'm Pharmacist Ben. 844-236-6010 is our number. Got lines open for you. We'll take a break and come back with more good health information and your phone calls right after this. Okay, we are back on The Bright Side. I'm Pharmacist Ben. 844-236-6010 is our number. We'll get your calls here in just a moment, and we do have a line open for you. From the proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, a new team of researchers from Carnegie Mellon University and the University of Oregon has used melanin, pigment, as an ingredient in a cocktail that has led to the creation of a biodegradable battery. This is a paper published in December of 2013 in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, and the researchers describe how they actually created a battery from melanoma, and they're proposing that this may be something that you can stick in your body in the future to run various devices, if you will, or maybe even to run electrical systems like your heart that are breaking down. This is what scientists are working on. That's called transhumanism, I suppose. The ultimate goal is to create a battery component that is made from a material created naturally in the body. This is some amazing stuff, you guys. We are bioelectrical systems, and this bioelectrical nature is run by chemistry, and one of the most important of the chemicals in the body that run this bioelectrical nature is pigment, is our tanning stuff, melanin, the color. If you're wondering about folks who have more of the melanin, African-Americans and Hispanics, well, it may be. And some people do believe this. In the book Melanin, the Chemical Key to Black Greatness, Carol Barnes actually believes that civilizations and cultures and races that have more melanin are more able to handle the stresses and specifically the electrical stresses, the solar stresses of life. And we know that melanin is an anti-sun or sun protective element. And according to Dr. Carol Barnes, anyway, it turns out he believes that more melanin means a greater ability to handle being human. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but you can certainly make a case for it, I suppose, given the unbelievable power, electrical power, associated with melanin. All right, so the adrenal glands help us handle stress, and one of the ways they help us handle stress is by increasing cellular fire, by increasing the body's ability to burn sugar for energy. Problem with using the adrenal glands for energy is the adrenal glands are only supposed to kick in once in a while. We have an emergency. They're not supposed to kick in all the time. We've created a culture in 21st century America where we're all running on adrenal energy. Over the course of time, the adrenal glands can only handle so much, so we end up crashing. So we go through these ups and downs of adrenal activation followed by adrenal fatigue. Can end up leaving us with a poor ability to respond to stress, subsequent crashing, hypoglycemia, frequent urination. These are all signs of adrenal fatigue or excess adrenal activity, constant thirst, inability to manage our salt. By the way, salt is one of the best things. Celtic sea salt or Himalayan salt is a great way to handle adrenal issues. The adrenal glands manage salt. This is why people feel better. When they have salt, when they drink salt water, this is why we crave salt. One of the silliest, and there's a lot of silly things doctors tell us, but one of the silliest things is to not eat salt. You can't not eat salt anyway. Now, sodium chloride, Morton salt, is not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about salt that has all your minerals. Of course, you're beyond Tangy Tangerine, and all the mineral products from Longevity will also get you minerals too. You can use Celtic sea salt, beyond Tangy Tangerine, whatever it is, for adrenal issues. Blood pressure issues can also follow adrenal health problems. In fact, there's a really interesting blood pressure problem that nobody ever calls a blood pressure problem called postural hypotension. It's where you change your posture and you get dizzy. Stand up real quickly or you stand up from a laying position or a sitting down position, or if you're working out maybe, you may start to feel a little dizzy or woozy. That's a classic sign that your adrenal glands are burning out. We'll talk tomorrow about the adrenal glands and blood pressure. And we'll talk about the adrenal glands and blood clotting, and we'll talk about the adrenal glands and the skin as well tomorrow and in the coming days on The Bright Side. Okay, 844-236-6010 is our number. Time to hit the phones. Let's go to Josh in Kansas. Welcome to The Bright Side. Josh, what's going on, man?
Hi, how are you? Thanks for the show today.
Sure.
I have been following along with you for some time and have gotten some good advice from you from some previous shows about herpes simplex virus.
Okay.
I unfortunately, I'm a healthcare worker, and I've been exposed to so many things. I actually have been exposed to cytomegalovirus, and I've had Epstein-Barr in the past as well, so I kind of have the trifecta of human viruses. And because of that, I deal significantly with horrific oral lesions that seem to occur in moments of high stress. And it's kind of worked with your show to come up with a regimen of some things that I've tried to keep those at bay. I have added some high dose vitamin C to my daily regimen. I'm taking about 3 grams of that a day.
When did you add that?
That's probably been just a couple months ago during this last horrific outbreak.
Are you doing it all at once? The 3 grams?
I'm splitting it up twice a day. I'm doing a 1500 in the morning and 1500 in the evening.
Doesn't affect your belly at all? Crampy or
it
weird?
It doesn't. No cramping, no diarrhea.
Okay, good. So are you noticing any differences since you started taking the high dose vitamin C? Which isn't high dose, but no?
No, not much.
Okay. How old? You sound young.
I am, 29.
Okay, well, you're too young for all this stuff. Something's going on. And you got to get to the bottom of it because it'll progress. It's not just going to stop. At the age of 29, these kinds of things shouldn't be happening. So what I would, you know, you always back, if you've been listening to me, you probably know what I'm going to say. You always backtrack to what's getting into the body that's causing this burden. As a healthcare professional, you probably recognize the body is perfect. The body knows what to do. The body doesn't have any problems handling the vicissitudes, the ups and downs of life. If it does have a problem, it's overloaded. You follow me? It's being burdened somehow. Now, it doesn't sound like you're an IV drug user, so stuff isn't getting into your blood through your skin.
No, sir.
That means only one way, right? What's the main way things get into the blood? Through the digestive system. Mm-hmm. So with all the stuff you've got going on, the problems with the mouth, by the way, the skin cells and the cells in the mouth, they turn over more rapidly probably than any other cells in the body. So that's going to be the first place that you notice things is in the mouth. And if you're breaking out in the mouth, you got canker sores, or sometimes people get something called lichen planus in the mouth. All of these health conditions are signs that something is getting into your blood that shouldn't be there. And that means food or a leaky gut. So you got to backtrack to the digestive system. And because you're so young, I would tell you that this is something that you'd want to do right away. I wouldn't be messing around at this point. Can you fast for a couple of days?
I can.
Okay, fast for a couple of days, and then when you start eating again, start with your favorite foods and eat a lot of them. Okay, that's going to be kind of fun for you. So pick your favorite foods and eat a lot of them. Watch what happens, and I can all but guarantee that you're going to notice that things that you love are causing digestive distress. You have to have, and if you don't know it, look for it. Some kind of digestive health issue. All right, loose stools or constipation or bloating or gas, something. You can't have all of these things going on, the cold sores and the poor response to stress and the problems in the mouth. You can't have all of these issues without having a digestive condition too. Does that make sense?
It does.
And then start focusing on digestive health supplements. Probiotics are a must-have. Get on the Biolumin Nightly Essence, 3 in the morning, 3 at night. If you're not using digestive enzymes, start. In fact, I would be using enzymes on an empty stomach as well. I don't know if you heard us talk to Troy Opperle last week about systemic enzymes. But because of the way we eat, we don't have enzymes. Vitamins themselves are coenzymes, but enzymes do the work. And because of the way we eat, we don't get enough enzymes. So you may be dealing with an enzyme deficiency as well. So make sure you're supplementing with the ultimate enzymes with meals and on an empty stomach, and make sure you're eating lots of live foods that contain enzymes. I'll tell you a couple more specific antiviral strategies for you. So don't go away, Josh. And hang tight if you're on hold. We'll get to you when we come back. I'm Pharmacist Ben. 844-236-6010 is our number. You're listening to The Bright Side. We'll be back after this. We are back on The Bright Side. Gonna go fast here. We got a full board of calls here. Josh in Kansas, cold sores and you're breaking out inside your mouth. What else did you say, Josh?
I ended up coming back positive for cytomegalovirus and Epstein-Barr.
Cytomegalovirus.
Yeah,
right.
Horrible.
All of these.
And all of that.
None of these are things that should happen to a 29-year-old. You should be able to handle viruses and bacteria without too much trouble. Sounds to me like you're either missing nutrients or something's getting into your blood inappropriately. So first thing you always want to do is backtrack to the digestive system, fast, and then stabilize the digestive system with supplements, especially probiotics, good bacteria, fermented foods also, vegetable juices, and then also digestive enzymes and using your digestive enzymes on an empty stomach. Now, it's great that you're doing the vitamin C. I would up the dose personally if it was me and see how high you can go without getting into cramping or diarrhea or just uncomfortable digestive symptoms. And then you also want to make sure you're using selenium, probably 400 to 600 micrograms a day. Selenium is powerfully antiviral. It may be the most antiviral of all. With vitamin C, it may be the most antiviral of all the nutrients, certainly the most antiviral of all the minerals. Zinc is also crazy important for the immune system. Absolutely, it's a must-have. You probably heard me talking about zinc because it's incredibly, incredibly important, and most people are deficient. You have to supplement with zinc, 50 milligrams a day, 50 milligrams a day. Look for zinc picolinate. A couple other interesting nutrients that may help you with your immune system as well as with your skin. Vitamin E, super-duper important, 400 international units a day at least. Use the mix tocopherol form, and also might not hurt you to get some tocotrienols. And then vitamin A is also very important for the immune system and for the skin. I would be doing 20,000 IU of vitamin A a day. Make sure you use your vitamin A with fats and fatty foods. Same with the vitamin E, and same with the selenium for that matter. Both the selenium, zinc, vitamin E, vitamin A, they're handled by the fat fat processing system of the body, bile, etc. So make sure you're taking them with fatty foods. Probably wouldn't hurt you to throw in the EFAs. Actually, I would be doing the Healthy Start Pack. You get the EFAs, you'll get the